This week at Interior.
The reality is that America leads the world in wilderness and wildlife conservation efforts.
Secretary Bernhardt joined President Trump and top officials this week for a White House event touting the administration's environmental and conservation efforts. The president saying that the nation has an obligation to protect its extraordinary blessings for generations to come.
From day one, my administration has made it a top priority to ensure that America is among the very cleanest air and cleanest water on the planet. We want the cleanest air. We want crystal clean water. And that's what we're doing, and that's what we're working on so hard.
Every day at Interior, we are increasing access to our public lands, increasing recreational opportunities on those public lands, and enhancing our conservation efforts. So thank you.
The Secretary this week also spoke to the American Farm Bureau Federation. Topics discussed included multiple-use management of America's public lands, improving public access to public lands, and grazing. The USGS is continuing to assess the accuracy and effectiveness of the ShakeAlert system after last week's 7.1 magnitude California earthquake. That quake followed a 6.4 magnitude quake 34 hours earlier. Many ShakeAlert users in Los Angeles weren't alerted for either earthquake, but that's because the app, correctly, predicted the most damaging shaking would occur elsewhere. Get the full story at usgs.gov. It's been 25 years since the deadly South Canyon fire in Colorado. 14 firefighters died in that blaze. As the 2019 fire season heats up, Interior is studying a system of so-called fuel breaks to protect fire-prone areas on BLM-managed lands in Idaho, Oregon, Washington, California, Nevada, and Utah. Secretary Bernhardt says Interior wants to hear feedback from the public on the plan. Check out BLM.gov. The Secretary is commending the selection of 8 buildings designed by architect Frank Lloyd Wright as World Heritage Sites. Those buildings now join such diverse landmarks and locations as Stonehenge, the Pyramids, and Grand Canyon National Park. See the list of those selected buildings at nps.gov. Richard Cardinale has been named the Executive Secretariat for the Department of the Interior. He previously served as the Business Operations Division Director in the Office of Chief Information Officer. Starting next week, the image of a full-size Saturn V rocket will be projected on the east face of the Washington Monument to mark the 50th anniversary of Apollo 11's historic landing on the moon. On July 16th, 17th, and 18th, the image will be stationary, but on the 19th and 20th, it will literally take off. The unprecedented event is part of a unique partnership between Interior and the Smithsonian's Air and Space Museum. Relive the Apollo missions at airandspace.si.edu. And speaking of unprecedented events, these were the unforgettable sights never before seen over the nation's capital as the Navy's Blue Angels, a B-2 stealth bomber, and other military aircraft took part in the Salute to America 4th of July Gala on the National Mall. Make sure you follow us on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. That's This Week at Interior.